Cerne Abbas, England. Standing proud on an English hillside, a 180-foot-tall chalk giant wielding a club and giant phallus.
So Cerne Abbas Giant is one of the most interesting and debated archaeological sites in southern Britain.
Despite being such a famous landmark, no one knows who the naked giant represents.
Southern England has a lot of other chalk figures. Kings, there's a horse that's 3,000 years old, but this is the largest figure and the most mysterious.
Now, can 21st century science finally unmask this secretive character and reveal his identity?
Historians have argued about this for years. Is he a Roman god? Is he an English warrior? Is he a fertility symbol? Nobody knows for sure.
These are questions some of the best academic minds have wrestled with for centuries. For some, the sheer scale of the man and his manhood points to one conclusion.
The Cerne Abbas Giant is really graphic. So this has led people to suggest that this is representative of some fertility god because of the sheer size of the penis.
The name Cerne actually derives from Cernunnos, who is a Celtic god of masculinity and fertility, which seems an appropriate name for someone who is this well endowed.
Typically, the deity Cernunnos is depicted with antlers. The chalk giant has no antlers, but that might not always be the case.
Archaeologists have long wondered if hidden clues to the giant's identity lie abandoned under the grass. Over centuries, the turf has been continually recut to stop nature reclaiming him. This even led to an involuntary enhancement.
Originally, the penis was a little shorter, and between 1900 and 1910, when it was recut in error to slightly increase the size of the offending member. And so we don't know exactly what we see today is what was originally cut into the hillside.
To check if any identifying features have been buried over time, the team employs a technique known as electrical resistivity. Metal probes send electrical currents underground to detect disturbances.
Geophysics suggests that under his left arm, we have remains of a feature which looks like a cloth or skin hanging down, and that's led people to suggest that this is a figure of Hercules brandishing a club, and over his arm, the skin of a Numidian lion, which he killed in Greek mythology.
If this is a depiction of the legendary Hercules, it would be an insult. This fabled son of Jupiter is a Roman god, an all-time hero.
But it does present problems, because why would you represent Hercules in this very caricature fashion with a gigantic penis?
With the arrival of the Romans in Britain, the god Hercules is very popular. And it's a figure that is very present and visible as a naked warrior with a club.
But further proof is needed. So, investigators turn to an ingenious dating technique called optically stimulated luminescence.
OSL works out when a particular sediment was last exposed to the air. And you can measure the luminescence of the soil, and that gives you a very accurate date of when it was buried.
But sourcing original chalk for dating presents an unexpected problem.
The figure has been renewed over the centuries, which involves ramming in new layers of chalk as older layers are washed away.
As the ground team scour the figure for traces of original chalk, they spot a strange anomaly.
The chalk around the elbow and the feet is thicker than the rest of the body.
Rainwater has continually flushed through the site, so it's pushed the original chalk to the extremities, and that's the best place to find the original chalk.
This could be the crucial breakthrough needed. The team excavate, and make a startling discovery.
In the debris, they find snail shells. And that's not that unusual for southern England. But what's really weird is that it's of a species that's non-native to England.
A series of tests confirm these alien snails are Cernuella vigarta, or vineyard snails. Crucially, they offer a chance to narrow down the age of the chalk giant.
They're believed to have been accidentally introduced to the British Isles in the 12th or 13th century in packing materials like straw. So what this tells us is that this Cerne giant can't predate the arrival of these snails.
This new evidence stuns the archaeological community. The Cerne giant is now likely to be medieval, centuries younger than anyone thought possible. Armed with this new information, investigators scour local records after the 12th century.
There is not a single reference for the giant until the late 17th century. And indeed, there is a very detailed map, which dates to 1617, that omits any mention of this hill figure at all. So taking those two bits of evidence, the giant must have been created during that gap between 1694 and 1617.
This suggests the Cerne giant was first carved during the English Civil War. Then, a power struggle raged between supporters of the monarchy and those favoring Parliament. It made Parliament's leader, Oliver Cromwell, a hugely divisive and hated figure.
So to me, the most likely explanation is the whole thing is a massive parody on Oliver Cromwell. We know that the Cerne Abbas landowner was a man called Dendal Hollis, Lord Hollis. Now, he rapidly fell out with Oliver Cromwell, who he believed to be a tyrant. Cromwell was known as the new Hercules. And so Hollis, in this remote bit of Dorset, in order to parody Cromwell, put this figure up of the naked Oliver Cromwell, shown as Hercules with a very large penis. The whole thing is a massive 17th century joke.